Hey guys, welcome to another video. This one's going to be on the Johnson & Johnson or Janssen vaccine for COVID-19. So there's a study called the ENSEMBLE Trial. It was a randomized, double-blind, placebo-controlled phase 3 study, meaning that thousands of patients were enrolled and it assessed the safety and efficacy of the vaccine. Now, unlike the Pfizer / BioNTech and Moderna vaccines, which are mRNA vaccines, the Johnson & Johnson vaccine is a recombinant vector, meaning it takes another virus, in this case an adenovirus, and then modifies that virus so that it can't cause infection in the body, but it can still deliver what it's supposed to deliver. And in this case, it's delivering the genetic code for a portion of the SARS-CoV-2 virus, specifically the genetic code that codes for the spike protein of the virus. Now, one of the huge advantages of this vaccine is that it's a single dose. The other big advantage of this vaccine is that it can remain stable for 2 years at negative 20 degrees Celsius, which is negative 4 degrees Fahrenheit. Also, at least 3 months of which can be at temperatures of 2 to 8 degrees Celsius, which is 36 to 46 degrees Fahrenheit. Why is this significant? Because that means, unlike the mRNA vaccines, regular refrigeration will suffice for mass distribution. So how effective is this vaccine? Well, in the ENSEMBLE trial, which enrolled over 43,000 people age 18 and older, not only from the United States, but also Latin America and South Africa, about 1% of patients enrolled in the study developed COVID-19. It was 66% effective at preventing moderate and severe COVID by day 28 after vaccination among all participants, including in those who lived in regions with the new emerging viral variant, such as the P1 variant in Brazil and the B1351 variant in South Africa. Protection against SARS-CoV-2 was greatest in the United States at 72% and worst in South Africa at 57%. About 95% of those in the trial who developed COVID-19 in South Africa were found to have been infected with the B1351 variant. That variant has been found to have some resistance to antibodies that were generated as a result of previous infections or previous vaccination. Within the B1351 variant, the E484K mutation has appeared sporadically in multiple samples for months, but until recently, it didn't appear to offer the virus any advantage in populations with no pre-existing immunity. But it's a different story in places like South Africa, where many people had been previously infected. In South Africa, there has been a very high rate of reinfection to the point where previous infection does not seem to protect you. So how much does this vaccine protect against severe disease? It was 85% effective in all regions by day 28, and there were no cases of severe COVID-19 after day 49. So does this mean that the Johnson & Johnson vaccine is 100% effective at preventing severe COVID-19 by day 49? Well, we're only going to know for sure with time, and once the full data from the study becomes available. Now, it's also worth noting that no one who received the Johnson & Johnson vaccine were hospitalized with COVID or died within 28 days of getting the vaccine. Now, being able to prevent severe disease in a high percentage of people, that's going to have a significant impact on alleviating the devastation from this virus. So, how safe is this vaccine? Serious adverse events, meaning side effects, were rare, with more participants in the placebo group reporting adverse events compared to the vaccine group. This implies that some of the adverse events reported by patients in the placebo arm may have contracted actual COVID disease. The overall rates of fever were 9%, and the percentage of people who developed high fevers, meaning grade 3 fevers, defined as greater than 39 degrees Celsius or more than 102.1 degrees Fahrenheit, that was 0.2%. So Johnson & Johnson will soon be filing for emergency use authorization in the United States, probably this week. This comes just in the nick of time because we have to have mass vaccination as quickly as possible before these new variants become the dominant strain. Because if that happens, the consequences could entail ineffective antibody protection, which means we would take a giant step backwards in getting this pandemic under control. Most Americans who are willing to wear masks and practice distancing are already doing so. And most people who are not willing to do these things, well, it's unlikely that they're going to change their ways. So far, about 450,000 Americans have died as a result of COVID, even if the entire population started doing everything right, meaning wearing masks and distancing, we're still likely to see over 100,000 deaths over the next 3 months. So realistically, we're much more likely to see way more than 100,000 people die over the next 3 months. So it's a race against time. It's not just about saving lives. It's also about getting as many shots in arms as possible before the new variants become the dominant strain. Because if that happens, then we're all going to be taking a huge step backwards. So that's all I have for this video. Thanks for watching. And if you haven't done so already, click on that subscribe button, hit that bell notification so you get notified of when my next one comes out. And I'll see you then.